What's up, people of the internet? I'm the Big Boat here with yet another video. In this video we'll be testing the Intel HD Graphics 630, which is an integrated GPU. It has 24 unified shaders. It uses system RAM as VRAM as its an iGPU, and it has a burst frequency of 1100 MHz in my case. I'm also using the latest drivers for it as of the making of the video. As for CPU power, we have a high quality Intel Core i7. And I don't think we'll notice any bottlenecks from it. I also undervolted it by -100 MV to reduce temperatures. We also have 16 GB of RAM in dual channel mode. Although 8 GB should also be enough for the game that we'll be playing today. As long as the operating system is installed on an SSD, such as my 256 GB NVMe one for example. I also have a 1 TB hard drive on which the game that we'll be running today is installed. As for operating system, we're using Atlas OS 21H2. For a full description of the specs, check out the video description down below. The game that we'll be benchmarking today is GTA 5, which is of course the best PC port ever. In my last video we tested the worst PC port, so now we are going to test the best one. And yeah, let's get straight to the point now.
but you! Woo-hoo-hoo.
Yeah. worry about it. bullshit.
Oh, I guess this is not a
So now that we saw how the best PC port, I guess, runs on my Intel HD Graphics 630, and I'm honestly impressed at how it runs. I mean, GTA 5 running alright with very high settings on measly Intel HD graphics is definitely something to behold. Let's begin the quest of squeezing out as much FPS as we possibly can. Let's start off with phase 1. Before proceeding, let's make sure to lower down every single option in the settings menu. Now we can proceed. So, in phase 1, we'll do a tiny little tweak in the game's config file. For reference, GTA 5's config file is located in Documents, Rockstar Games, GTA 5, settings.xml. Open the settings file with Notepad, and here's a config. See that shadow quality value? Let's lower it down to 0. In other words, we are getting rid of the game's shadows. And after going back to the game, if you open the settings menu, you can see that the shadow quality option says undefined. Now let's go. Damn, so removing the shadows is already enough for 60 plus FPS average. Now let's proceed to phase 2. In phase 2, in the config file, we are going to tweak some other stuff. First of all, these epic LOD values, LOD scale, pedestrian LOD bus, vehicle LOD bus, and the most significant of them all, maximum LOD scale. In addition, we have the reflection MIB blur value. If we set it to false, we will disable the reflections of the cars. Now to the LOD values, I will set all of them to minus 0.4, followed by 5 zeros, otherwise it won't work. What we are doing is, we are lowering the draw distance further from the lowest one allowed by default. Let's also disable some other effects. As for the resolution, I will lower it from 800 by 600 to 640 by 400, although if you use a newer version or the paid version of the game, frame scaling mode will also do the job. For the lower resolution to take effect, I will have to set the windowed value to 2, which will actually make GTA 5 run in windowed borderless mode. Still, if you want to make it full screen, you can just lower the desktop resolution to the aforementioned one. You know, if I had no other choice but to play GTA 5 with these graphics, I could still enjoy doing so. Still, we aren't done with the quest yet, so it's Phase 3's turn. This time, we are only going to lower the draw distance and resolution further. The LOD scale will go down to -0.7. The pedestrian and vehicle LOD biases will be slightly reduced to 0.5, while the maximum LOD scale will be greatly reduced to 0.8. As for the resolution, I will lower it to 400 by 300, which is truly a sharp resolution. I'm even going to risk lowering my desktop resolution to the 300p one for the full screen effect, you know. wow, even GTA San Andreas looks better at this point, but the quest continues. So, phase 4 Jude, we will lower both the LOD scale and pedestrian LOD bias to minus 2, and yes, minus 2 is the lowest that the LOD parameters can go down to, while the vehicle LOD bias will go to minus 0.75, and the maximum LOD scale will go to minus 1. Now, what resolution should we use for phase 4? Why, of course, 320x200, the most beautiful resolution from the old Celeron N2840 days.
Coming. Thank you. dead don't drive.
To end the video, I'm going to kill the Intel HD Graphics 630.